Do not let this be a condole, Zana, something that precludes you from approaching my throne room, something that precludes you from pressing into my presence, something that prohibits you from pressing your way to me, said the Lord. He said, welcome. He said, I hear the Lord say, you're welcome into my presence despite the situation. He said, you're welcome into my presence despite the adversity. You're welcome into my presence. And he's preparing a table. He's preparing a table. I see in the spirit, the Lord's preparing a table. He said, the table is prepared for the weary and the weary at heart, saith the Spirit of God. I'm preparing a table this morning so that you can just eat and commune. The Lord, there's that word communion again. And this is communion Sunday. The Lord says he wants to commune with you in a new way. So the Lord said, disconnect yourself from the warfare in this moment so that you can be in my presence. Oh, God, I give you praise for that. I give you the glory for that. I give you the honor, Lord. Father, we come into your presence, nothing holding us back, withholding nothing. We give you the situation. We give you this. Oh, we give
yes,
you the circumstance.
Yes, we do, Lord.
We give it all to you this morning. Father, you want to bless us. You want to touch us. You want to, oh God, so empower us. And you want to restore us. So, Father, we yield to that this morning. Yes, Lord. We yield to that this morning. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Yes, God.
I think we should go right into Lord. I'm telling you, the presence of God is so strong.
Thank you, Father.
I think we need to go right into communion this morning. And I want you to just spend this next 6 minutes just worshiping with this song this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we feel your presence here with us this morning, Lord God. We are so grateful.
Yes,
we are so grateful to you, Father. We are so grateful to you this morning, Lord God. Hallelujah. Oh, Rabasharia, Koso Toyesando. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I pray to God, all of you are feeling his presence. It is so strong. Thank you, Jesus.
You were the word at the beginning, one with God, the
worship him this morning.
Hidden glory in creation, and now revealed in you are Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ.
be with the Lamb. All holy God, you are holy.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Sharif, you want to just go ahead and lead us into prayer right now?
Father, we so feel your presence right now on this, Lord God, on this prayer, Lord God, on this line, God. Lord God, we so feel your presence, oh God, just near to us right now. Father, we want to sit at your table and commune with you, oh God. Just wash us right now, God. Wash us and cleanse us, oh God. Purify us, oh God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, God, if there be anything in us that is not like you, oh God, just forgive us, Lord God. Just sanctify us, oh God, and purify us, oh God. We want to commune with you. We want to commune with you, Lord God. We want to feel the sweetness of your presence as we commune with you right now. So, Father, we thank you. We honor you right now. Father, we give you your name all the glory, honor, and praise, and we glorify you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Elder Jackie at this time.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Such a beautiful day. It might be hot outside, but it ain't as hot as hell, right? Praise God. It's so good to see everybody this morning. I want to share with you a clip of some things that the Lord has been sharing with me about communion. As we all know, a lot of things have changed, and we all know that a lot of things won't ever be the same like they were before. So I just want you to kind of listen to me first. It's going to be short, but I want you to just open your heart and hear him this morning, because this is a real communion like we've not had before.
Yes, Lord.
I want to read to you from 1 Corinthians chapter 11, and I'm going to read verse 23. 24 and 25. And this is out of another translation, but I'll give you a chance to pull it up in yours.
What translation?
It's the Holzman translation, Holzman Christian translation. And it says, "Let me go over with you again exactly what goes on in the Lord's Supper. And why it is so, so, certainly important. I received my instructions from the Master himself, and he passed them on to you. The Master Jesus on the right hand, the Master Jesus on the night of his betrayal took bread. Having given thanks, he broke it. This is my body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, he did the same thing with the cup. This is the cup, is my blood, my new covenant with you. Each time you drink this cup, you remember me. I want to say that both the songs this morning were very pointed and right on the mark, because one of the things that took place for me in verse 24 was when he said, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Pastor Michelle and I went to a fellowship last year, early part of last year. And at that fellowship, we went to a lady in Virginia. And the lady's house that we went to, she was Jewish. She was Messianic Jew. And she was having dinner for everyone. And in her having dinner for everyone, there were couples there and singles. And everyone was going around the table sharing an important experience they had with the Lord. And as they shared their experience, by the time it had come back, or it had come around the table to me, I realized that I was there, but I wasn't there and seeing the people. What I was seeing at the table was the face of Jesus. And when I say I saw the face of Jesus, I saw the Isaiah 53 face of Jesus. I saw where his body was broken. I saw where his body was bruised. I saw where his body was wounded. I saw the marks. I saw the thorns on his head. I saw the nails in his hands. I saw the nails in his feet. I saw the piercing in his side. But I saw it in individuals who had come together, and they were giving an expression of the body of Christ in miniature that helped me comprehend. So I say to you this morning, when you come to partake of communion, when you partake of that bread, I want you to recognize, I'm asking you to recognize that you are partaking of not just your life, but every life that was laid down in the body of Christ. For the body of Christ to be whole and complete, so that all that which was within us is swallowed up. And the way that it is swallowed up and surrendered unto him is the yielding of the right of way to his ownership. He purchased every vessel to the maximum, from Adam to the very breath we are now breathing, to every breath that is breathing, and to every breath that shall breathe. It is the body of Christ. He said, Father, lo, I come in the volume of the book that is written of me to do thy will. A body thou hast prepared. Every trauma, every situation, every ugly thing, every great thing, every miraculous thing was the preparation of his body. For we are members in particular of the body of Christ. Yes. It is our obligation. It is our free will obligation that when I see you, I must not recognize you no longer after the flesh, but I must recognize the body of Christ.
Amen.
So when you partake, when you eat of this bread, when you share your life, they are eating of his body. When you share your experiences, when you share your hopes, when you share your brokenness, when you share your truth, when you share your lies, when you share that which is real and unreal, when you share your imagination, when you share your job, when you share where you go and what you do, what you understand, what you do not understand, what you're hoping for, you are sharing the life of Christ.
Amen.
You are not sharing, I'm not sharing Jacqueline Averine Fuller Hewell. I am sharing with you the life of Christ that is made alive and real to me.
Amen.
Okay. Thank you, Lord. I want you to hear something. I want you to hear what the word dismember means. To cut off, to disdain, to disjoint a limb, members of a part, to break up or tear down in pieces, to smash, to fracture, to rupture, to shatter, to split, to crack, and to sever. It means that that body is not working. It's out of order. It had to be out of order. It's out of action. It is damaged. It's under arrest, and it's been captured. It's been disintegrated, it's been crumbled, it's been collapsed, it's been broken down, it's been split, it has gone a wreck, okay? The key one that stood to me was the word rib, and it also means to rave. It means to wrench open. It means to tear apart, and it means to cut into pieces. And that's what the enemy has done to the body of Christ.
That's right.
One of the other meanings is to split. And when I saw this meaning, I understood what happened to our communities around the world. Split means to crack. What has been what was the most dominant drug in every community, in every city, in every state, was crack, okay? In every community, every race, every nation, every economy, every health, every financial status, it affected all seven mountains. It penetrated, it opened a door for what's happening right now. but the body of Christ have the answer.
Yes, we do.
One more thing, and then I'm finished, and we're going to enjoy the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
I want to give you a short definition of member. A member is a building block. A member is a component. A member is a constitute. A member is an element. A member is a factor. A member is an ingredient. A member is a portion, a part, a piece, a division, a section, or a segment. And the antonyms that go along with members mean to be whole. Mean to be whole.
Thank you, Jesus.
So I want to say to you this morning that the things that are on this side, we're going to cross over today.
Amen.
We're going to cross over today in community. Every one of us know the traditional sightings and the traditional wordings that go along with communion. Today, I'm going to ask you to take your bread. And I'm going to ask you to give your bread to the Lord first. I'm going to ask you to give your bread to Him first. Because in everything that Jesus did, all of His life, everything, at His true end, He gave the kingdom back to the Father. He did not keep it and build up Himself. He gave it back. So I'm asking you today to give it back to Him today. We are His purchased possession. We are the redeemed of the Lord. And let us give thanks and praise unto God for how He broke us. How He broke us to be served, to be servants to the life and the body of Christ. Let us eat and partake of life in the name of Jesus. This blood, this grape juice represents the blood of Jesus. The new DNA, the new life, which is Christ. And everything that we surrender to Him receives a new covering. It receives new life. If you surrender something today and it doesn't work, surrender again tomorrow. Just keep going. Whatever's hurting, what needs to be fixed, surrender it. There was a little joke. That lamb don't want to be slain. And when you grab him, he goes, cut his throat. We receive the blood of Jesus. We receive the new covenant. We receive the new life. And in all of our ways, we acknowledge Him that He is Lord, God, King, and Christ. I thank you so much for allowing me to share with you today. I bless you in all of the name of Jesus and the life of Christ that is in you. And I call forth that life and it more abundant. And we are headed for everlasting joy.
Yes.
To be upon us. Oh, we receive the garment of praise by the spirit of worship today, that we can worship Him in spirit and truth. God bless you today. God bless you.
Amen. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. what a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful time of communion this morning. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you so much.
We love you, Lord. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul, rejoice, take joy, my King, in what you hear, let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Ooh, his presence is so rich this morning, isn't it? Wow.
Heavy.
Wow, wow. Thank you, Jesus. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. Alice read a little earlier, for a day in your courts is better than a thousand. I'd rather be the doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. For the Lord God is a sun and a shield, a sun and a shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from those who walk uprightly. And boy, if that's not the truth this morning. He has given us the sweetness of his spirit this morning, and we can rejoice. Woo! We can rejoice in him. Thank you, Jesus. And Father, right now, this would be a time where we would give, sow our seeds into the kingdom of God. I want to encourage you guys to go on PayPal and sow your seeds this morning. But Lord, we sow seeds from our heart of rejoicing. For your presence is truly with us this morning, O God. And we sow our seeds of rejoicing into you, Father, as we bless your name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Whew, my God. Thank you, Jesus. I want to read something to you from 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 13. I'm going to read it in both the New King James Version and the Passion. Therefore, laying aside all malice and deceit, hypocrisy, envy, evil speaking, as newborn babes desire the pure milk of the word, that you may grow thereby, if indeed you have tasted that the Lord is gracious. Boy, have we tasted that this morning. In the Passion, it says, so abandon every form of evil, deceit, hypocrisy, feelings of jealousy and slander. In the same way that the nursing infants cry for milk, you must intensely, hear that word, intensely crave the pure spiritual milk of God's word. For this milk will cause you to grow in maturity, fully nourished and strong for life, especially now that you've had the taste of the goodness of the Lord Jehovah. And you've experienced his kindness. And I would say that would be true for all of us this morning. Amen. I have a little PowerPoint I'd like to share with us this morning. And man, I'm not going to be long because I don't need to be long this morning. The Lord's really already done it. But I have a few things that I would like to share with you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. The title of my message this morning is An Unexpected Dip. And passion is what we've been talking about this morning. That's really what this is all about, passion. What catches your heart? What connects you with the Lord? It's His presence. When you take an opportunity and His presence is with us like it is this morning, doesn't it capture your heart? Doesn't it make you feel like, oh, you could just do anything, right? I'm going to ask the Gibbs to go ahead and unmute themselves and read this Jeremiah 31:3 for us, please. Maybe Alice will have to unmute. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and read it. I didn't think about it. You there?
Can you hear us, Maya?
Okay, we can hear you now. Go ahead.
Jeremiah 31:3. The Lord hath appeared of old unto me, saying, yea, I have loved thee with an everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness have I drawn thee.
Thank you. The Lord spoke that to the people of Israel. I've loved you with an everlasting love. That verse is so beautiful, not only because it reveals the depth of the Father's love towards us, but also because it demonstrates God's passion. As He said, He's drawing us into His presence. So it represents His passion for us. Amen? And I want to read 1 John verse chapter 4, verse 9 and 10. God showed how much He loved us by sending His one and only Son into the world that we might have eternal life through Him. This is real love. Not that we love God, but that He loved us and sent His Son to sacrifice to take our sins away. Jesus was the sacrifice, and we know that. And you know what? We're in a time and a season right now where there are such there is a mess. The world is a mess. And last night I was watching a PBS special about the Titans, and they were talking about Mussolini and Hitler and Japan and China and all of these things where there was a power play in the world. And even in the United States, there is a power play going on. But we need to have the power play for the passion of God. God's people have got to have a passion for God. The Bible says in John 3:16 that God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. And then the next verse says, but God sent His Son into the world not to condemn the world, but that the world through Him would be saved. Now, we forget about that. And so do believers. Not to condemn the world, but the world through Him. And we represent Him so that we can be His light in this earth to save the people through His love. Sharif, can you read that next scripture, please?
Romans 8. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Yes, God.
That is powerful. Nothing can separate us from the love of God except ourselves. When we're not focused on that passionate love that He has for us. The Apostle Paul wrote this in Corinth in like 57-58 AD. And it's one of the longest letters that he wrote. And the book of Romans is one of the most important books in the Bible. It tells us so much about how we're children of God and how what God thinks about us. Lisa, can you read that Isaiah 67:1, please?
Was it 61:7 or 67:1?
I'm sorry, 61:7.
Okay. 61:7, Isaiah. Instead of your shame, you shall have double honor. And instead of confusion, they shall rejoice in their portion. Therefore, in their land, they shall possess double. Everlasting joy shall be theirs.
Hallelujah. Oh my goodness. The whole church should be standing up and shouting right now. Instead of your shame,
yes,
we have double honor. Instead of confusion, yes,
hallelujah,
thank you, Lord,
they shall rejoice, ooh, in their portion. Therefore,
yes,
in their land,
thank
they
you,
shall
Lord,
double. We get double, guys. We get double. We don't get a half,
yes,
a portion. We don't get
thank
a quarter
Lord
of a portion. We get double. And the Lord broke that 740 years before Jesus.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
God isn't ashamed
you,
of us. He knew everything. He knows everything. And the things we participated in the past weren't enough to stop his love for us. Our screw-ups were not enough for him to say, I'm ashamed of you. Our mess-ups were not enough for him to say, I don't love you. He's still giving us a double portion in spite of ourselves. Come on now. Come on. I want to tell you a story about Benji, but let me digress here for a minute. I want to tell you a story about Mookie this morning. Mookie hasn't been to my house for a month because I've been sick. And I went to see Sharif yesterday, but really Mookie thought I was coming to see him. He jumped on me. He kissed me. If he could have climbed inside of me, he would have climbed inside of me. And he was so excited to see me. And it's such a picture of Jesus. It's such a picture of what happens when we take our time to spend time with him. And then we get in our flesh, don't we? And this morning, Mr. Mookie Wilson decided, for some reason, he hasn't done this in a long time, that he was going to jump on the table and eat Luigi's food. Well, Miss Faye saw the food on the table, and she left the room, and she came back, and guess what, Miss Jackie? The food was gone. Now, she said, well, maybe Guido did it. No, Guido didn't do it. I know who did it. It was Mr. Wilson, Mr. Four-Footed Wilson. And I looked at him and I said, did you get on that table and eat that food? He puts his ears back and he looks at me like, well, you know, it was me. And 5 minutes later, he comes to me, apologizes, wags his tail, and wants hugs and kisses. That's what we do when we screw up. We have to go right back to Jesus, and we have to lay it at his feet, don't we? Sometimes we screw up more than once a day. Sometimes the condition of our heart makes us do that. But I want to tell you this story about Benji this morning. Benji was a dog that we had before we got Luigi, and Benji lived to be 17 years old. And he went everywhere with us, and he really didn't need, he wasn't like Luigi, the great escape artist. Benji would go with us and he wouldn't leave our side, and except if you were on a farm. And then he'd like to roll in the horse poop. I have a picture of him under a racehorse. We're washing the racehorse and we're washing Benji at the same time because he stopped, dropped, and rolled in the field. But that's another story. But this day we were with Debbie and Ed Moskowitz, and they were living up in northern Baltimore County. And they were living in this barn that had been converted to a house. It was really fabulous. And they had beautiful grounds. And you know, Ed, he's such a landscaper. He makes everything beautiful. The pond was a heart-shaped pond. And Benji was running around the field, and Debbie and Ed had planted tulips all around the pond. And then those big red flowers. The big, they look like, you know, I call them fire flowers. They're about 3-4 foot tall, and they were planted all around. So it's really beautiful. We were just walking and talking, and we weren't really paying attention to Benji. And all of a sudden, out of the corner of my eye, I'm like, Benji just took off. He took off running, and there was no stopping him. And I called him, Benji, Benji, Benji. He wasn't going to listen to me. Benji had his eye on a frog. And Benji took off running. That frog took off running for the pond. And Benji was so passionate about catching a prize that he jumped into the pond after the frog. See, the prize for Benji was catching the frog. A surprise for Benji was that he landed in the water. He landed in the pond, and the pond, because of the time of year, had that slime over the top of it. And guess what? The frog got away. The frog got away. Now, are you surprised? Romans 8, 38 and 39 says, who can separate us from the love of God? Right? Sharif read that. Nothing can separate us from the love of God, but here's Benji going after the prize, right? He thought he was going to get it. His eye was focused, but the surprise was he was focused on the frog and not paying attention that he was getting ready to land into the water. So we literally had to fish him out with a pole, and his white coat comes up out of the water full of green slime, and he still wants to know, where is the frog? The frog was gone. What keeps us from the prize in our life? See, the frog was just the diversion for Benji. It's the passion of what's in us that will keep us focused on the Lord. Because if we don't stay focused on the Lord, we're going to be like Benji. We're going to take off running after something that looks like the prize, and we're going to wind up in a hole. And then Holy Spirit's going to have to fish us out. And guess what? Benji had to get another bath that day. And it was a cold bath because we couldn't take him inside because of the green slime that was all over him. And we had to wash him. And we had to dry him off. And then he was just broke, busted, and disgusted, as Pastor Tom says. Because he missed the prize, right? How many times have we done that in Jesus? How many times have we focused on God's word? We have a plan and we get sidetracked. Well, I can tell you, COVID will sidetrack you. The fear of COVID will sidetrack you. The reason I didn't put it out on Facebook, the reason I've been selectively telling people about the fact that I had COVID is because of the fear factor. You see, people are so afraid of this disease, and it is scary, and it was horrible being sick. But God, you see, all of you right there, out there on Zoom right now, the people who are in this room prayed for us, prayed for Faye, prayed for me, and guess what? We're not a statistic of death, as we hear on the news every day. We're a statistic of the keeping power of Jesus Christ. So the slime might have hit us, but because we kept our eye focused on him, we kept our eye on the prize of Jesus Christ, we're sitting here today worshiping with you. 1 Peter 1:13 says, therefore, gird up the loins of your mind and rest your hope fully upon the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. I'm going to read it in the Passion. You know, it's Faye Redinger's fault that we're into the Passion. So then prepare your hearts and minds for action. Stay alert. Fix your hope firmly on the marvelous grace that's coming to you. For when Jesus Christ is unveiled, a greater measure of grace will be released to you. And that is where our passion has to go. Our passion has to lead us into that place where we are going to stop right here. This is our resting place. We're going to stop right here in the passion of the Lord. We're going to stop right here and focus on what he's saying. We're going to rest right here. The communion today was so rich, wasn't it? And when Jackie said, lift this body, lift your body up and surrender it to the Lord. And what he gives us back is always way more than we ever thought. It's always, have you ever been blessed by the Lord and it's what you thought it was going to be? I know I haven't. It's always been the more. That scripture we read back in Jeremiah, the double portion. See, the frog was just the diversion. And we've got to get past these places of diversion. We've got to come out of complacency. We've got to focus on him. There is so much work to be done. If we never go to another foreign country, United States of America needs the body of Christ to be passionately focused on him right now. We have to be. Jesus never, ever has taken his eyes off the prize. He has never taken his focus off of us. His word talks about us. His word declares his blessings for us. His word tells us everything that we need to know. So are we being complacent or are we being passionate? We get diverted, guys, but I want to take you and take the lasso out there, that hook, like we had to get Benji out of the pond, and I want to pull you back in to the passion of the Lord this morning. I want to pull you back in and tell you to hone your mind, your thoughts, your thinking process on not what you want to do, but what you want to do in him and through him in this hour. Because we need the body of Christ to be on point. This is from Randy Walter. It says, my word says, and this is one of their conversations out of their book, In Timeless Wisdom. My word says, all my sheep hear my voice, but when I call them, they don't all raise their heads at once. The nearest ones hear me first. The ones farther away, if their ears are tuned to my voice, those on the fringes continue grazing until I call louder or walk in their direction. There are also some rebellious sheep who belong to me, but they do what they want. Sometimes they're more interested in the pastures than the pastor, Jesus. Then I have to go after them. And when I read that the other day, when he sent that out, I thought, oh my God, that is so right on time. Just so right on time. Isaiah 65:1 says, I revealed myself to those who did not ask for me. I was found by those who didn't seek me. To a nation that didn't call my name, I said, here I am. The Lord is drawing us. And some of us have felt like we've been tarred and feathered. See this picture? But there is a crack in the tar, in the blacktop out there. I have a perfect picture, and I wish I would have thought about putting it up here. In the crack of the cement of my front yard, there is a snapdragon coming up through the cement. How did it do that? Well, somehow, some way, that little seed got down in that crack, and when spring came, it came to life. Spring is here. You have to push through. There's a blacktop that the enemy's tried to put over us called deceit. It's deceit through depression. It's deceit through COVID. It's deceit through the lies. It's deceit through everything you can name out there that's going on. Civil unrest, racism. But God, and you have an opportunity this morning. And instead of chasing the frog like Benji did and getting full of slime and having to be cleaned up again, you can look at the prize of Christ Jesus. You can take his word for what it says. You can rest in his promise. You can do that. I'm going to stop share right now because I really want to challenge each of you this morning. How are you going to pursue the Lord from this point? What are you going to do? You know, Robert and Annette, we've been doing this Reformation of the 21st Century Church online on Wednesdays from 8 to 9. And it's really good. We're only on chapter 4. You can send out the Zoom link every week. You can click on with us. We are opening church next week. We're going to be together. I'm going to ask everybody, wear your masks, right? You want to be together, just wear your mask. It's not, you know, it's not a big deal. When I go to hug you, go like this. This is my hug to you, right? It's very hard. I'm going to have to do this. I'm going to have to tie my hands together so my arms can't get around you because I love you so much. But this little body of believers are powerful men and women of God. We are powerful and mighty to the pulling down of strongholds. Isn't that what the word says? But we can't be like Benji. We can't chase the frog into the pond. We got to stay focused. We got to have our face fixed like a flint before the Lord. Because there's something great that God wants this motley crew of people, red and yellow, black and white, 15 to 85, that he wants us to do something for his kingdom. And he put us together for such a time as this. So I want to encourage you guys this morning, do not lose focus. Stay focused on him. I want to thank Robert and Annette for filling in these past couple of weeks for me. I mean, that first week when we came on Zoom, I was so sick, I just crawled up in that chair, and that was all she wrote. But I tell you what, the fire of God is in me, the passion of the Holy Spirit's come forth, and if we were all together this morning, I don't even know if I would have preached, because the worship was rich, the communion time was rich, and I'm so looking forward to us being together next week. So I want to leave you with this today. So please pray for one another. You got the message that Marty's dad passed, 89 years old. He passed this week. So they're in the process of getting all that together. There's so many other things that are going on, but we have each other, guys. Lori's been going through all of this stuff with her ex-husband, taking him to dialysis, having to spend all that time. I mean, I can go down the list for all of you of things that we've had to go through, things that we're going through. We don't know what's going to happen, you know, in the next couple of months with COVID. I see we have a little friend, Miss Lisa. We don't know what's going to happen with our economy. They are saying that we should put money aside and have cash on hand, that we should have food in our refrigerator, that we should stock up on staple items. Well, maybe we should. Maybe we should just take that wisdom. Maybe when we can get Clorox, buy the Clorox. When we can get hand sanitizer, we buy the hand sanitizer. We don't need to look at that as such a bad thing. It's just the way it is, right? Because in an instant, we might have to board up our houses. We don't know. We don't know this. In an instant, we all may have to congregate at the church and hang out together because we don't have any other choice. We don't know what the world is going to do tomorrow. But Jesus said, don't worry about it, because I've overcome the world. And Jesus told us to be encouraged in his love. And Jesus said that he is greater than all things. And in Psalm 91, it says, if you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you can abide under the shadow of the Almighty. So we have to stay focused on the Lord so that he doesn't have to come from afar and say, hey, guys, hello. He doesn't have to leave the 99 to go catch the one who's fallen away, jumped into the pond chasing a frog, because it's time to pay attention to the Lord. We can stay focused on him and know that he has our back. Can I get an amen?
Amen. Amen.
I want to close with this one song today. I just want you to worship the Lord. If you have any prayer requests, listen, join us on Tuesday for prayer. Join us on Thursday for prayer. Join us on Wednesday for Bible study. It's more than Bible study. It's equipping the leader study. It's helping us to look at what God said about this 21st century church. Join us. We're going to be doing everything via live and Zoom. So for the Gibbs, we're so happy to have you with us on Sunday mornings. Lisa, can you, or Alice, can you unmute everybody so that we can just greet one another? We've got about 10 minutes here that if you have something to say, I want you to raise your hand so I can call on you. Well, Lisa.
All right, I can't control that now. Sorry. Ah, it is what it is.
Anybody have left that they want to say this morning?
Who's that?
Praise the Lord. Communion was wonderful, and the worship time. I want to thank you and Sister Jackie, Elder Jackie, and Sharif for the worship, the word, and encouragement, and just that amazing teaching on communion as well.
Amen.
Yes.
Beautiful
thank
time
you,
in the Dawn, Lord.
You're next.
Yeah, I am. Good morning, everyone. I had to move indoors. My neighbor decided to cut the grass. No, I just want to say that, you know, the Lord's been good and been giving me opportunities to share. We have a gentleman at church who got married, and his wife, a couple years ago, she fell and hit her head, and she's paralyzed on one side of her body. And because of the way the insurances and stuff are set up, she's been shuffled from rehab to rehab. And then he has to bring her home, and he's did FMLA and all this. So it's been a real ordeal for them. And I was talking to him. He called in the office for some stuff, and I talked to him, and I asked how his wife was. And he was telling me that, you know, she's getting ready to get kicked out of her rehab again, and they don't have anywhere for her to go. And they've been fighting with the state and all this stuff. So I said, you know what, Rick? I said, I'm just going to pray for her. Her name is Patty, so y'all can keep praying for her. And he came into the office Friday to bring me some test papers, and he got all excited. And he's like, Patty's coming home. He said, it must have been your prayers.
Amen.
He said, because the state has finally admitted that since they don't have anywhere where she can go, because all of these centers are closed, so now she's coming home, and they're providing her with home health care during the day while he's working. Yeah. So just keep that in prayer. Amen. Amen. Just keep that in prayer, you know. But I just looked at him and said, you know, Rick, we're his children, and all we have to do is ask.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, and I told him we're going to keep praying that her caregiver will be competent and compassionate and concerned.
Yeah.
So just wanted to give that prayer, that praise report, and put out that prayer request.
Amen.
To continue to pray for Pat.
Alice, you were next.
Yes, I just wanted to say that your word today was just on target, because I've been so focused on packing up and moving. I'm not been able to really focus on God so like I should.
Okay.
And
Pray for me that I'll be able to do that.
Yes.
Yes, amen.
Thank you. Yes, amen. Anybody else?
There's a message from Laureen in the chat. I wasn't able to read it fully, but it looks like she has a prayer request.
Okay.
I can't find my glasses.
That's okay. I'll pull it up.
Okay. I got it. Great word. Powerful communion. Please keep my family, Jazz and my mother, in prayer for healing and peace during these times. We are doing very well and blessed, but we are all fighting a spiritual warfare, but we know who ends in victory. Amen. Prayers for Africa, the Conies.
Mm-hmm.
Send their love and are doing well. Love you all. Thank you for a blessed morning.
You are welcome. You are welcome. Thank you, Father. Okay, who? Anyone else have something to say this morning?
It was amazing.
Amazing.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Amen. Wonderful, 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 wonderful service, and the presence was here.
I know. I can feel it. I can still feel it.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Thank you, Lord.
All right, church.
That's great.
Are all hearts clear this morning?
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Okay, I'm going to close out with this song.
Sharif was saying something.
Go ahead, Sharif.
Yeah, I still think, like somebody else said, that the word was so spot on this morning, but I really feel led to read this scripture again, just in case someone didn't get it the first time. I really feel like that this is what God is really putting emphasis on this morning. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. But I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah.
Yeah, I'd like to just emphasize that scripture again that Sharif just was expounding on, is that the reason we can't be separated is he put himself on the inside of us on Pentecost. Jeremiah 31:31 is the new covenant that he promised, that he wrote it inside of us, so we can't lose it, and he isn't going to lose us.
Amen.
We are marked with the Holy Spirit on the inside of us.
Man.
Hallelujah. Doesn't matter how you feel.
Hallelujah.
We're not going to lose God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
And I'd like to say how rich this whole morning was. Rich.
Yes.
It's a milestone. This was a milestone Sunday here. And we'll look back and see that it was a milestone, setting a standard for what's coming up.
Yes.
So I'm glad that you recorded this.
Yes.
And because we need to see it again, and in the future, we're going to need to see it. So I'm sure you're going to post it on YouTube as well.
Yep.
So it can continually be seen, because it's going to need to be seen in the future.
Amen.
All kinds of things. And that communion,
It was. Let me tell you,
we have to hear it again.
Let me just tell you how that came about.
Mm-hmm.
You know my friend Jackie.
We know some.
She calls me. And she starts talking, and I feel the presence of the Lord. And I said, what's going on? And she begins to tell me about what happened during the time of communion. And the Holy Spirit comes in, and we both, this river's going back and forth and back and forth. Wow. I said, well, it's Communion Sunday. Guess who's going to be doing communion this Sunday? Glory to God. And it was so rich.
I only told him a little tea.
She's got 4 pages. She said she only shared this much with us.
It's a seminar.
Oh, Carolyn was able to get on. Praise God.
Hey, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hi, Carolyn.
You know, we were, Faye and I, you know, Faye is like in the same river here with the communion. And she just said, you know, we've got to take the communion up to another level. She's been saying this for months. And so now we have the pattern for the communion. It has been elevated into the God realm that it's supposed to be. So, hallelujah. All right, guys.
For me, when I first came to the Lord, the first time I took communion after, after that commitment to the Lord, communion was a celebration for me.
Did you hear that? Communion was a celebration for her.
You know, just taking it to take it. It was a celebration. And it can be. And it's meant to be, I believe.
Yes, it is meant to be.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Lord.
Party. Instead of being all morbid about it.
That's right.
It's a party.
It is. It's a whole party.
Yes. Praise Him.
In what room she's in? She's in Tom's room upstairs.
Thank Amen. You, Jesus.
Thank you, Father. Amen. That was wonderful.
This song with this. Listen up. God of
creation. What a wonderful way to.
There at the start, before the beginning of time.
As you speak.
Okay,
you have to
dark and fleshed out the wonder of life. And as you speak, 100 billion galaxies are born.
Sorry.
Nature and science.
telling us.
Thank you. To lift you high.
Hallelujah.
To that song every day, that version of it, that young man was so passionately anointed to sing that song. Guys, come on, be encouraged today. Hallelujah. Can we just thank the Lord for all he's done in us?
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. God. Father, thank you, Father. This morning, Lord, as we come to a place and we're ending Zoom service, we will continue to worship on with you. We will continue to stay in your presence today. We will continue to fulfill that place that you've carved out in your heart for us. We crawl up inside of you today. 100 billion stars are in the sky. And so is your presence here with us, Lord Jesus. Oh God, we bless you and we thank you. We magnify your name and we give you all the glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. And all the church said,
amen.
Amen. Amen.
Pastor, yes. Lorraine said that through worship, healing has started taking place in her house.
Come on. Sharif, go ahead and pray into that right now. Let's just pray into healing.
Oh, yes, God. In the name of Jesus, Father, let your supernatural healing, oh God, flood that house in Jesus' mighty name, God. Let your healing river flow through that house. Let your healing river, God, flow through that house, oh God. Oh God, let healing rivers, holy Abbasia, healing rain, God, let it flood that house, God. Oh, healing rains, God, let it pour into that house. We decree healing rivers, oh God, are flooding that house even now, God. Oh, God, healing rain is flowing in that house, oh God. Every crack, every crevice, oh God. Oh God, every ceiling, oh God, every wall, oh God. Oh God, touch every place, every part of that house, oh God. Healing rivers, oh God. Let your healing rain, God. Let your healing rain, God. Oh Father, we touch and agree right now, oh God. Healing is taking place. Oh God, that freedom is coming, oh God. Oh God, that wholeness is coming, oh God, and that it is here, oh God. Oh, let your healing presence. Woo! Yes, God.
Thank you, Lord. Anybody else let need prayer healing this morning? Raise your hand if you need prayer this morning.
Yes, God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Yes, God.
Thank you.
Yes, God. Father, we just pray for Lori even right now. Let your anointed supernatural balm in Gilead, oh God. Father, we know that she has been dealing with a lot, oh God. We know that she's been carrying a lot, oh God. Let the weight of your glory just fall on her even now, oh God. Oh God, that it may overcome her, oh God. That even in the warfare, oh God, you would give her that opportunity to slip away in your presence. Oh God, to slip away in your presence, oh God, to find rest, oh God. Oh God, to find peace and comfort, oh God. Oh God, she's carrying a lot, oh God. Oh God, for the family, oh God, and even in her heart, oh God. Oh God, as she is, oh Lord God, you have shown her the blueprint, oh God, of deliverance, oh God, for so many people, oh God. Oh God, give her the strategies, oh God. Oh God, to walk this thing out, oh God. Oh God, give her the strategies, oh God. Oh God, just to walk in this thing, oh God. Oh God, so that it don't be a weight, oh God. Oh God, you said in your word that my burdens are easy, oh God. Oh God, and so Father, I just pray, oh God, that you would just alleviate pressure, oh God, alleviate stress, oh God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, God, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you.
Thank you, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Father. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I have a word.
Go ahead. You have a word for the Gibbs?
Yeah, I just keep seeing a report. And the Lord's saying, don't receive the report. Set it on fire. I just see this thing just burning, like putting it in the trash can. So just don't receive the report. It's not over till the Lord says it's over. So,
my God.
Yeah, wait, now the Gibbs are muted, so let me see if I can unmute them. You guys are going to have to unmute yourself if you want to talk, Robert.
Okay.
I'm going to ask you to. There you go. You're unmuted. Yes. Did you hear what Lori said?
Yes.
I did. Yes. Praise the Lord. Thank you for that word. Amen. Hallelujah. The word says, whose report do you believe? I shall believe the report of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
His word is yea and amen. Hallelujah. I thank you for this whole service. It has been so awesome. The worship, the praise. I mean, the word of God. I mean, the body of Christ coming together. It is so wonderful to have each other. And we need to really thank and appreciate the Father for knitting our hearts together in one mind and one accord. Hallelujah, great things will happen, greater things than you've ever seen before. Yes, because I have the Lord thy God that brought before thee, I will make every crooked path straight, saith the Lord. Oh, God, thank you, Jesus. And a river of rivers shall flow, saith the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Annette, go ahead.
Yeah, this is to go with the word that Lori just gave and that they received. You know, a word fitly spoken is like apples of gold and pitchers of silver. And when you give a word that is in that season, in that time, it becomes a verily, verily, surely, surely. It's about on you right now. And that is this very week. Do you know what week this is? This, what? We are in the week of the 9th of Av.
The 9th of Av, yes.
And what did that commemorate? It commemorated the curse that fell upon Israel because they didn't believe the report of the Lord of how good the land was that he promised them. And therefore came the curses of the destruction of both temples, and they used that to destroy all the Jews in Spain, drive them out of Spain, drive them out of this, and also kill them in Germany. So that you are receiving the report of the Lord and believing him before you see him, that his word is true, and you're waiting on the word, and you received it at this time. This is big.
Yes.
Amen.
Good word, Lori.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God. Thank you, Lord.
All right, guys.
I'm also seeing such a, it's bigger than a breakthrough. It's big. It's like it's going to happen overnight. It's, I'm seeing so much wealth coming so fast. I'm not kidding. It's going to be like overnight. And it's like the wealth of the wicked comes to us overnight. And
wow, thank you, Father. Ready.
Because we need to hire, I mean, guys, this is big. We have to hire attorneys. We're going to have to hire CFOs, CPAs. I mean, everything you can imagine. You can't imagine.
We receive
and
that.
It's like the and ask the Lord, what do we need to do next?
Yes.
Because it's going to come so fast, so like a tidal wave.
Come on.
We've got to get ready and asking the Lord what we need to start thinking about, because there's a lot of information out there that we really need to get organized. We need to get our homes ready, because I know I'll be moving quick, and I think it's going to be in Maryland close by. And I've already seen a house I want. I've heard about it, but it's way out of my price range right now. I mean, way out. And he's just preparing me to get ready, because when that happens, it's going to be people coming, getting ministered to. It's an enjoying like a retreat center for people to come and just bask in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
I'm also seeing a heaven portal coming through that house. And I'm seeing it in your houses too. When we're worshiping and praising the Lord like never before, it just comes and it stays with us. And we're cleaning the land. I'm believing about buying land for people, and they can. And we're going to clean it up, and we're going to use it for the glory of God. And it's like never, never, never before. I just wish I could show you what I'm seeing, but it's so exciting. It's you're going to be so impressed with God. It is going to be unbelievable.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Go ahead, Annette, and then Lisa.
Well, this just goes again, exactly, Diane, with emphasizing what Diane just said. Because if you really believe what she said, then you act like a wealthy person.
Yes.
And you start learning the things you don't know about money. You never had money, so what did you need to learn it for?
Very good.
Well, you best look into it, because we do not operate as in the spiritual world. We are spirits operating in this world, and Jesus had a lot to say about money. And we need to know how it operates, not how it's going to own us, but how we are going to separate it out. That's now, right. Robert and I teach about your mission. Well, this is part of everybody's mission. If you believe that God is going to release money, you need to have a written plan of how you see it going in. How much money can you live on and use the rest for the Lord? Because he doesn't just want you to do it one way or another way. He doesn't expect you to be meagerly poor when he's pouring in the money. But when you set it, see, there's no high bar that the devil can't enter in. And so you need this for yourself. So you need to plan ahead of time before it's released. How much money will you be satisfied to live on, for yourself, to take care of your family, blah, 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 blah. And then how you're going to build the kingdom. It should be written out. And then start studying where you're going to invest it and all of that, as if you were already that wealthy person. Plus, you invite Jesus in to tell you, because we're in a way we've never been before. We don't know if the bottom is going to drop out of this particular economy or what. And where the money should be invested, as Jesus talked a lot about that, so that whatever you get becomes more. So it's really important in faith to start doing these things, which build a foundation to take you further doing the will of God, which can zoom it across around the world to bring in the harvest in a million different ways.
Also, he gave me Zion Oil stock to pray about it, but Zion Oil, it's real low right now, but it's going to catapult out, so it's low. Just pray about it and see what you think.
Amen. Okay, Lisa was next. Lisa.
So I stepped outside because, there I go, upside down, sorry. the little boy, he loves the presence of God. He was so courteous. He left right when the preaching, the word started. He shut the door quiet. And then like an hour later, like clockwork, he is back in. And, I was gonna say, just Diane, thank you for that. You've shared about that before. And this whole, not the entire quarantine, this pandemic time is just, what God's been showing me about getting my house in order, not getting, it's got, but that's the opportunity that we've had to do that. And I appreciate apostles reminding us about, putting it in writing, how big is your vision that God is giving you, basically. And, and I really feel that that's what he's wanting to do, for the people of God that are, walking in integrity and walking after him. But also, with finances, a lot of us, we haven't had, I know I haven't had hundreds of thousands, I've had thousands, how to handle that. You see people that, they win a lot of money, lottery, and then they're broke 6 months later. So that's something that really I've been trying to learn more about, finances, being a wiser steward, but also, sitting and talking with someone that knows about that, like retirement, stuff like that, pension if you have it, because all that can be gone in the blink of an eye. But I believe God is, he's pouring it out, he's restoring things, but that he does want us to have wisdom and how to operate, and just for us to just make sure our house is in order and clean. One day when I got home, where I'm renting here, it's almost like at the end of a court, and there's actually a playground there, and I know people sit in their cars and do drugs down there. It's very inconspicuous unless you recognize it, but, or they're buying whatever they're doing. But one night I came home and I just went, did a U-turn and parked, because I sometimes park facing out, and I think they thought I was, like, you know, checking them out to see what they were doing. So as I get up out of my car comes creeping up slow with his lights on. I'm like, I don't play that. No. So I just waited for them to pass, and, you know, but it made me angry. You know, I don't know why I reacted that way, but the next day I bought a broom, I bought trash bags, I went down there and I picked up all the trash where in that little cul-de-sac, mm-hmm. In the playground. I swept. I know it was hot out too. I was sweating. And I know some neighbors drove by. They're like, what that black girl doing there? You know, I live with Asian folks. So they're looking like, not these people, but the other neighbors are like, okay. Should we call the police? No. But anyway, so I cleaned it up. I took my anointing oil and I anointed all around down there. So sometimes what the enemy means, not sometimes, all the time, but the family's evil God. And I believe, even though I will not be living here soon in Jesus' name, because God is going to provide, you know, my house, my home. But I believe that I planted a seed for, you know, whatever the purpose was for me to do that. I believe my obedience will, it will be revealed, you know, as time comes in this community, that God will reclaim what he needs to reclaim this community in the playground. You know, it's always where the children play that people want to do their thing, sell drugs, and it's always, you know, where the innocence needs to be. So I believe that that's why God had me do that. So, but Diana, thank you for that reminder that we really do need to, you know, be prepared. And the apostles to have wisdom to know what that looks like to be prepared.
Amen.
You know, so, yeah. So, anyway, thank you.
You're welcome. Mm-hmm. All right. Anybody else raising their hand? I do not mind the after service. You know that. Sometimes in the after service, we get those nuggets that we can carry with us for the rest of the week. So, if all hearts are clear now, okay, is that... Dawn wanting to say something?
Yes.
Okay.
I'll put my hand down now. I just want to get Jackie, revisit your communion thing. Do you recall we were at pastor's house and we were sitting around the table and we were praying? This is like back when this COVID started, you know, to come about. And I had a vision about the communion, the bread, the Lord was... He was breaking off the bread, and as each piece broke off, it was bread. But when it went to go into someone's mouth, it was a person.
Wow.
And that also with the cup, and, you know, that there was wine poured in the cup, but what was coming out of the cup were people that were being consumed. And the Lord had said that we are the bread. And we, because he's in us, his life is in us, we are the life and the blood that is spilled out to other people. And I just, the Lord brought that back to me as you were speaking, sister, to give a visualization to what it is what you were saying today, in case someone didn't quite understand, you know, or just something to remember when you take communion. It's not just symbolic. Every day, our lives are communion when we give out Christ, when we interact. And, you know, and sometimes I think we forget that, you know, that we, you know, he was our bread, now we are bread. He was our wine, our blood, so now we are wine and blood for others. Mm-hmm. So...
That was powerful.
Yeah, that's just the way I felt that was how that was interpreted.
Yeah. No.
Thank you.
That's why I didn't get it.
Along with that,
Amen.
Because along, I'm going to stand right here. And along with that, while we're imparting to others, it's important for us to understand and remember we are in the body of Christ. Mm-hmm. We're not just the body of Christ. We are in the body of Christ. Your heart is not on the outside of you. Your heart is on the inside.
Yes.
We are in the body of Christ. And Amen. As the body of Christ, if she lose this hand, as a member of the body of Christ, I can remember her hand. Mm-hmm. Not here, but here. Mm-hmm. Here. New fingers, new toes, new ligaments, new joints. Just like Lazarus, he did Lazarus as whole out of the body. But we're doing it in parts because we're connected in parts. And each joint supplying to the body. Mm-hmm. So whatever body part needs to be remembered, we can remember it.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
That is good. Yes.
Hallelujah,
Jesus.
Amen. Good.
Yes. Are we going to continue the communion next?
And about the finances, let me tell you, children of God, Father said to me, I was talking to this person right here, this sister right here.
She beat me up,
and he said to me, words rolled across my belly. Go beyond possible.
Mm-hmm. Mm. That's right.
And I said, okay. And as we're talking, he says, go into impossible.
Step into
impossible and stay there until I manifest it in your life. Because Jesus told us, he said, with men, these things are impossible. But with God, all things are possible. So the things with men that are impossible, let's do it.
Amen.
Let's do it. Let's enjoy this thing because we ain't got that much longer. No way. But anyway, let's enjoy it.
Yes.
Okay. So, Luigi, are we going to say goodbye to everybody today?
Oh, my goodness. Hi, Luigi.
Man, I'm telling you, I'm ready to look. If we were here at church, we'd still be at church. Do you understand? It would be 5:00 before we would be done today. The power of God is so awesome. Go ahead.
Can I say something real quick? Yeah. You know that light on the wall behind Faye, I think it's just the sunlight, but it just, I don't know if anyone else sees it. It just looks like this, I don't know, those pictures when you see where it shows the empty tomb and the light is like bursting out of it.
Oh, yeah, I see that.
That's what it,
yes,
that's
I've
what
noticed
like.
That earlier, too. I noticed that light. Yes.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Yeah. Praise God.
Yes, hallelujah.
I didn't know
All right. Wait a minute. Did you hear what she said? She didn't know she was such an angel. I think on that note, we better pray ourselves out of here because we're going to get it.
She's an angel.
Robert, why don't you pray us out of here today?
Father, in the precious name of Jesus, we just thank you for this time together. We thank you for your word. We thank you that you have said that you would show us great and wonderful things that we know not. So, Lord, you've showed us great and wonderful things today that we can understand. And, Lord, as we take these things to heart and we move out in your grace and in your power, we become that world-changing force that we've been talking about. So, Lord, we ask you for your blessing, your anointing, your power to go forth in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Amen.
I love you. And the Lord says to dream big.
Amen.
Dream big. Beyond anything you can imagine. And he's told me to dream bigger than what I can possibly dream. I don't know how to get any higher than that, but he said keep dreaming. So don't limit him.
Okay.
Wow. Let him go. Let him go.
All right, everybody.
I love you.
Love you. Bye. God bless y'all. Love y'all. Bye-bye.
Love you.
Bye-bye.